24-yard run by quarterback Unruh. Takes it out to the 39-yard line. Good enough for a Wildcat. First and 10 Wildcats on the 39-yard line. Coughlin, the ball carrier, about a 1 yard gain to midfield, brings up second down and 9. Smith and 14 Herbal combined on the tackle of Kaufman, who gains about 8 on that play, bringing up third down and short for the Wildcats. Kaufman with the carry, gains 1 yard, but that is good enough for a Wildcat. First and 10 Wildcats on the 35-yard line. Correction, the 30-yard line. Colin Cole, the ball carrier. There is a flag down in the middle of the field, though. Preliminary signal is holding against the Wildcats. Yards brings up second down and 12 for the Wildcats. Combined on the tackle, ball carrier for the Wildcats, number 20, Colin Cole. About an 8 yard gain, brings up third down and 3-4. Flags down on the play. Preliminary signal is a legal procedure false start on the Wildcats. That'll back them up 5 yards. It'll be third down and 9. is complete. To Schlosser. On the tackle, number 10, Hines. A 13-yard pass play, good enough for a Wildcat. First and 10 Wildcats from the Gorilla 16.
Procedure against the Wildcats. The Gorillas have elected to take it first and 10 on the 30-yard line. It'll be first down, Solomon.
Keeper loses a yard, courtesy of the tackle of Wildcat Aaron Green. He'll bring up second down and 11.
Tackled by Schlosser. Carrier was Herbal once again. Gain is good enough for a Gorilla's first down this time. Number 10, Hines, the ball carrier. No gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10.
Number 10, the ball carrier once again. This time picks up about 11 yards, 10 yards. Good enough for Gorilla's first down. Helms with the tackle in the backfield that time after about a 5-yard loss. We are going to get a timeout called by the Gorillas, their first charge of the half. Ball carrier on that play was number 10, Hines. It'll be second down and 15 coming up after the timeout. I would also invite you to stick around this evening for some halftime entertainment. I know the Mound Ridge cheerleaders have been working on a dance routine that you may want to see, and there will also be some grant awarding courtesy of the Mound Ridge Community Foundation. Made by Doherty. Number 10, the ball carrier, after about a 6-yard gain, brings up third down and a long 9. Pass falls incomplete. That brings up third down and about 9 or 10. Excuse me, fourth down and 10. Nice catch there in the end zone by the Gorillas. Number 89, Kirby, on the reception for the two-pointer. With just under 2 minutes to go in the first, the game is knotted up at 8. Wildcats set to receive the next kickoff. Schlosser on the return. Currently the ball sits at about the 17-yard line, pending a penalty flag here on the Wildcat sideline.
Preliminary signal is maybe holding on the defense.
Call is illegal use of hands against the Wildcats.
On them.
Current spot is the 17. We know we're going to move it back. Ten-yard penalty moves the ball back to the 7-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 for the Wildcats from the 7.
Yes, Dawson.
Colin Cole, your ball carrier, picks up 3 yards. Tackle made on the play by number 4 for the Gorillas, Dawson Durea. Be second down and 7. Fumble on the play. Recovered by the Wildcats. On the fumble, we have about a 1 yard gain. It'll be third down, and let's call it 6. Coach Brett Lang, ladies and gentlemen. However, the pass does fall incomplete. It'll be fourth down and 6. Goes right to midfield. It'll be first and 10 for the Gorillas from the 40-yard line. Number 10, Hines, the ball carrier. Kaufman with the tackle. About a 1 yard loss. Brings up second down and 11. And folks, that is the conclusion of the first quarter. We're going to move the ball across midfield here and have Second down and 11 going the other direction when we return. Schlosser with the tackle, number 14, Herbal the ball carrier, 6 yard gain, brings up third down and 5. Little pressure on the quarterback that time. Does force an incomplete pass and bring up fourth down and 5 for the Gorillas. That'll be a timeout charge to the Gorillas, their second charge timeout of the half. I do have it on good authority that pumpkins will once again be for sale this year. We've got a little while to go. It's only September, so hold your horses. But I can tell you without a doubt that pumpkins will be for sale on October the 18th. Just in time to get that Halloween spirit machine up and rolling. I have just been handed the first half joke of the game. It's more of a fun fact. Did you know that before the invention of the crowbar, crows drank at home? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That is the first half joke of the game. Pass ball is incomplete. There is a flag down on the play, however. Call on the field is a legal man downfield. And the flag is actually being disregarded. So it'll be a turnover on downs, first down and 10, Mound Ridge. Your ball carrier for the Wildcats. Number four, the tackler for the Gorillas. 10-yard gain, good enough for a Wildcat. Fumble on the play by quarterback Unruh, recovered by quarterback Unruh. 2-yard loss. Let's say a 1-yard loss brings up second down and 11. Number 10, Hines, the tackle. Back to the original line of scrimmage, it'll be third down and 10. Number four, Durea, the pick for the Gorillas. That'll be a turnover. It'll be first and 10, Solomon at the 25-yard line. Do have a couple of score updates for you. In the second quarter, Central Plains 14, Kinsley 6. Canton Galva, a local favorite, 28. They're playing center this evening, and center has 0. Carriers Hines, tackled by Schlosser. 2-yard gain brings up third down and 8. Carrier picks up about 3 yards. Kaufman in on the tackle along with a couple of the Wildcats. It'll be fourth down and 4. Got a timeout on the field. This one charged to the Wildcats. It'll be their first timeout of the half. Thank you.
Yes!
Doherty with the tackle. Quarterback Herbal, the keeper. He does pick up enough for the Gorilla first down. It'll be first and 10 Solomon at the 35-yard line. Second down and 10. Helms into the backfield with a 2-yard loss on the tackle. Number 14, Herbal, the quarterback. With the carry, it'll bring up third down and 12. Illegal procedure, false start the call against the Gorillas. It'll back them up 5. Brings up third down and 17. Of scrimmage, it'll be fourth down and 10 for the Gorillas on the 35-yard line. On the tip to self, interception there on fourth down to Brady Helms. We do have a penalty against the Gorillas for an illegal shift. And that penalty, as expected, is declined. Interception stand, it'll be first down and 10 Wildcats. Hoffman, the ball carrier, loses one. Number 10 into the backfield. That's Hines with the tackle. It'll be second down and about 11. Go! ball carrier that time. A nice gain of about 8 yards. Brings up third down, and let's call it 3. Passes just barely tipped there at the line of scrimmage. It'll be 4th down and 3. Second charge timeout of the half by the Wildcats as they ponder 4th down and 3. Once again, take this opportunity to remind you, stick around at halftime for a special presentation by the Mound Ridge High School cheerleaders, as well as a special presentation on behalf of the Mound Ridge Community Foundation. Foundation grants. If you are here as a grant award recipient tonight, at about the 2-minute mark in the first half, if you could meet down at the light pole closest to the concession stand, you're going to look for Hillary Hecox there. She's easy to find, folks. She's waving right now. There she is, America, ladies and gentlemen. Hillary Hecox, meet her at about 2-minute mark in the first half down by the light pole, please, and thank you. On 4th down, the pass play is nicely defended by the Gorillas. It'll be a turnover on downs. 1st and 10, Solomon. Schlosser, the tackle, number 10. Hines, the ball carrier. Short gain on the play. We'll call it 2nd down and a long 9. Number 10, Hines, the ball carrier, picks up about 4, brings up 3rd down and 6. Dan Kaufman into the backfield with the tackle on quarterback Herbal. About a 5-yard loss, brings up 4th down and 11. Get him back! On fourth down, they take a 5-yard loss on the attempted punt. They'll bring up first down and 10 for the Wildcats from the 20. First and 10 Wildcats on the 21-yard line. One play, one completion, touchdown pass for the Wildcats. Quarterback Unruh to number 2, Brady Helms. Touchdown, Wildcats. Movement on the Wildcat line will be a legal procedure, false start against the Wildcats. Repeat the try. Two-point try falls incomplete, but with about 2.5 minutes to go in the first half, your Wildcats now 14, the visiting Gorillas 8. It'll be first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Number 10, the ball carrier, that's Hines. Tackled by Schlosser. Brings up third down and 8. A reminder again, if you're part of the Mound Ridge Community Foundation presentation, please start making your way to the light pole on the north end zone. And everyone else, please stay around for halftime. The cheerleaders have a special performance. Corbin Undery with the tackle, 14.
Herbal, the ball carrier. About a 6-yard gain on the play, brings up fourth down and 2.
I would also take this opportunity to remind you that After Prom is still selling those raffle tickets, 50-50. Could be $1,000, could be $10,000 in that pot tonight, folks. You could walk home with $5,000. That'd be a sweet deal, and it might only cost you a dollar. Get in there, support After Prom, and maybe take some jingle home in your pocket this evening. Number 28, Aaron Green, the tackle. Number 10, the ball carrier. Good enough for Gorilla's first down as the clock rolls here. John Schlosser, the tackle of quarterback Herbal. About an 8-yard gain. Leaves us with 2nd and 2. Carrier did go out of bounds, so the clock has stopped for 2nd and 2. Again, number 10, Hines, the ball carrier. 87, Schlosser, the tackle. It is good enough for yet another Gorilla first down. First down and 10, Solomon at the 35-yard line. Once again, I call John Schlosser's name on the tackle. Number 10, Hines, the ball carrier for a 7-yard gain. It is the 3rd and final charged timeout of the half to the Gorillas
with 39.1 seconds remaining. Don't forget also to stop at some point here and grab a nice little face or hand tattoo courtesy of the cheerleaders and Mound Ridge Communications Network.
Mound Ridge Communications Network and the Mound Ridge Telephone Company are proud sponsors of this game here tonight. Don't be surprised when the cheerleaders are lobbing t-shirts your way, courtesy of Mound Ridge Telephone Company, coming up in the second half.
Herbal does slip. It is 3rd down and 7.
Pass intended for number 4 falls incomplete. That'll bring up 4th down and 7. Come on, come on, come on, come on. 17-yard pass play up to the 25-yard line. Good for Gorillas first down. Pass is incomplete on first down. It'll be first down and second down correction and 10. Timeout charge to the Wildcats, their second of the half. $1,800 to West Zion Mennonite Church for their weekly children's meal program.
$1,500 to Mercy Hospital for emergency communications equipment and emergency response supplies.
$1,500 to the Moundridge Senior Center to replace flooring in the quilt room. $2,000 to the Moundridge Youth Ministries Meal Program, which is accepted by Don and Bonnie Kaufman and Dwight Suderman. And $2,000 given to the Valley Hope of Moundridge for the Hope Builder Club. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause to our grant recipients, as well as the Moundridge Community Foundation for their generous support of so many great... America League action. Marion 8, Douglas 0. In other local action, Canton Galva 42, Center 0.
Start the second half, it will be the Gorillas receiving the opening kickoff. Is a touchback. It'll be first and 10 from the 15 for the Gorillas. Made by Kaufman and Helms, also Falco. 1 yard gain on the play brings up second down and 9. Flag down on the play, ball carrier was number 14. Corbin under the tackle. Penalty is personal foul for a horse collar against the Wildcats. Here's another local score that might be of interest to the Wildcat fans. Upcoming opponent Pratt Skyline 26, Argonia Attica 14. It'll be a 15-yard penalty from the spot. Be first and 10 for the Gorillas on the 37-yard line. Kaufman on the tackle. Yeah! 4 yard gain brings up second down and 6.
Go defense!
Ball carrier that time was Hines. Once again, the tackler, Kaufman. Gain is good enough for a Solomon first down. However, it'll be first down and 10 in Wildcat territory. There is a flag down on the play. There was a touchdown, but we'll see what that looks like pending the penalty flag. Signal is a legal block in the back against the Gorillas. That'll bring back that touchdown run. So it'll be 10 yards from the spot of the foul, but it will remain first down. So it will be first down and about 4 for the Gorillas, right smack dab on the 25-yard line. Inside the 20-yard line. Number 10, your ball carrier. Short loss on the play brings up second down and 11. Down on the play. We'll sort this out. Pass play is complete. It was tackled by the Wildcats, and it is at this point about a 6-yard gain, depending on the outcome of penalty flags. Setting penalties for a personal foul face mask. We also had a sideline warning against Solomon. And we're going to wind it up and replay second down. The ball carrier, 17 Doherty with the tackle. Be about a 7-yard gain, brings up third down and 3.
Go defense!
two-point attempt is not successful. But in about 3.5 minutes, the Gorillas go down the field, taking it 65 yards for a touchdown. Nice return there by Colin Cole from the 10, just about over midfield. We're at about the 34-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 Wildcats. I'm going to take this opportunity to remind you, I do see some young kids playing here on the south end of the field, and I would remind you that if you are here tonight with a student who is sixth grade or under, you do need to please be supervising that student at all times during tonight's ball game. Once again, if you have a child down there running around on the pits, please make sure to collect them. Nice run across midfield for Daniel Kaufman, met there by several of the Gorillas. That gain, however, good enough for a Wildcat. First and 10 Wildcats. Number 5, Acosta on the tackle. Pass is complete from Unruh to Cole for about a 4-yard gain. Brings up 2nd down and 6. Number 14, Herbal, forces Wildcat ball carrier Kaufman out of bounds. That's a 14-yard gain by Kaufman. Good enough for a Wildcat. First and 10 Wildcats. Unruh the ball carrier, number 14, Herbal the tackle. 5-yard gain, brings up 2nd down and 5 from about the 9-yard line. Have an official's timeout. Thank you.
carry that time, Colin Cole. Number 89, Kirby with the tackle. Cole gets it down to the 2-yard line, gain of about 7 yards. Gain is good for another Wildcat. First and 10, correction, first and goal Wildcat from the 2.
For that time by number 10 Unruh, takes it around the left side for a Wildcat touchdown. Two-point conversion is successful for the Wildcats on the pass play.
At just over the halfway mark to go here in the third quarter, your Wildcats now lead 22-14. Tackled by several Wildcats. It'll be first down and 10 for the Gorillas on the 13-yard line. Flag. Signal is personal foul, horse collar tackle against the Wildcats. It'll be 15 yards from the spot of the foul. That will be good enough for a Gorilla first down. That'll be first and 10 Solomon at the 30-yard line.
Hines is the ball carrier. About a 1-yard gain, brings up second down and 9. Yeah.
carry goes across midfield. Nice gain on the play up to the 30. Good for a Gorilla first down. Short loss on the play after a fumble brings up second down and a long 10, maybe short 11. Got a 5-yard gain on the play. Stop made by Doherty. Number 14, Herbal, the ball carrier, will bring up third down and 6. Herbal, the ball carrier, helms the tackle. Fourth down and 4 to go.
Have to see what the call is here. Signal is offside against the Wildcats. It'll be 5-yard play. It'll bring up first and 10 for the Gorillas. First down pass play falls incomplete. That'll bring up second down and 10. I do have a final on the Little River game. Little River 51, Bennington 6. Too many Wildcat defenders to make the catch, but it is knocked down. It'll be third down and 10.
Another Heart of America League score for you. I've got El Saline 27, Trinity Catholic 0.
Once again, a nice quick run there by quarterback Herbal around the left side. Good for a Gorilla touchdown.
Nice defensive stop means that the two-point conversion is no good. So with just under 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, the visiting Gorillas now 20, your Wildcats 22. Kickoff coming up.
Red and black! Our colors! Red and black! Our colors! Red and black!
It'll be first down and 10 for the Wildcats on the 15-yard line.
Midfield. Forty-two yards on that play by Daniel Kaufman. Good enough for a Wildcat.
Do it again.
Like someone unloosed the joystick on that one. That's a nice Wildcat touchdown, folks. Three-point conversion try is successful.
On about two plays, the Wildcats strike back. 30-20 now with 3 minutes and 4 seconds left in your third quarter.
Another score update from the Heart of America League. Inman 15, Whitewater Remington 7 in the fourth quarter.
Kickoff into the end zone, first down and 10, Gorillas on the 15.
There is a flag down on the play after the tackle for loss. We'll see what this is. be a face mask call against the Wildcats. Be a 5-yard penalty from the spot, but it will be first down and 7 to go now. Number 10, Hines, with the carry. Gains about a yard on the play, brings up second down and a long 6. Fumble on the plate, recovered by the quarterback. Timeout on the field, called by the Gorillas, their first of the half. And I've got your Mound Ridge High School Art Department joke of the second half. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The question is, what do sprinters eat before a race?
And the answer is nothing. They fast. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mound Ridge High School Art Department, joke of the game. Nice pass play, nice catch there by number 89, Kirby. It is good enough for Gorilla, first down. The tackle, about a 2-yard gain, brings up second down and 8. No flags on the play. Touchdown, Gorillas. That's a 45-yard touchdown run by quarterback Herbal for the Gorillas. Kickoff.
We fell in the alley and we kept him over here.
Nice run back there by Wildcat Anthony Everhart. Right out to about midfield, it'll be first down and 10 for the Wildcats. Ball carrier was Kaufman, loses about two on the play. It'll bring up second down and 12. We'll call that a 13-yard gain by running back Kaufman. Good enough for a Wildcat. And at this point, ladies and gentlemen, the play looks like it will conclude the third quarter. As we switch ends and head to the fourth quarter, the Wildcats still currently lead 30-26. Sheep here in the press box. Let's see one. Put it off the window. Let's go. All right, hit those t-shirts. Thank you to the Madridge Telephone Company, the Madridge Communications Network, for your support tonight. We regroup for the fourth quarter. I do have another joke for you. The bonus joke tonight is, what do you call a boat full of polite football players? A good sportsmanship. Ladies and gentlemen, the bonus joke. Number 14, Herbal, the tackle. Colin Cole, the ball carrier, picks up 11. Gain, good enough for a Wildcat. Carrier picks up about one on the play. That brings up second down and 9.
a beautiful diving catch and a great effort. Unfortunately, it's out of bounds. It'll bring up third down for the Wildcats. Carrier was Kaufman, tackle made by number 14, Herbal. It'll be fourth down and about 3 yards to go for the Wildcats. Timeout charge to the Wildcats. We believe that's their first charge of the half. Falls incomplete on fourth down. That will be a turnover on downs. It'll be first down and 10 for the Gorillas. Signal is a legal procedure. False start against the Wildcats. It'll be a 5-yard penalty. It'll be a first down and 15. Correction, that's against the Gorillas. It'll be first down and 15. Herbal, the ball carrier, helms the tackle. On first down, gain of about 2, it'll bring up second down and 13. Yeah!
number 14, once again the ball carrier.
Quite a few Wildcats met him there. It'll be a short gain on the play. Brings up third down and 12.
Pass falls incomplete. That'll bring it fourth down at 12. Nice return there for Cole. Ends up in a net punt of about 4 yards. That'll bring a first down and 10 for the Wildcats from the 15. Number 5, that's Acosta on the tackle. Ball carrier for the Wildcats is Kaufman. Picks up about, we'll say 14 yards. Brings up first down and goal for the Wildcats from about the 2.
Successful.
Just under 8 minutes remaining in our fourth quarter this evening. Your Wildcats now 38, the visiting Gorillas 26.
Yeah.
flag down on the play. Return goes out to about the 25-yard line, pending the penalty. Signal is against the Gorillas. Signal is blocking the back. It'll be a 10-yard penalty. First down and 10 for the Gorillas from about the 15-yard line. Touchdown, but there is a flag down near the line of scrimmage. And the signal is holding against the Gorillas. Ends up being about first down and 17 from the 8-yard line for the Gorillas. Hines on the ball carry. Number 17, Doherty, the tackle. Let's say he picks up 10 yards on the play, brings up third, correction, second down and 7. Durea, the ball carrier. Cole, the tackle. Short loss brings up third down and 8. Yet another long touchdown run, pending the penalty flags. Preliminary signal is personal foul, face mask against the Wildcats. That'll be declined. Touchdown, Gorillas. That was number 14. Once again, the quarterback, Alex Herbelin. 63 yards on that carry for the touchdown. Two-point try falls just short. So, halfway through the fourth quarter, the visiting Gorillas now 32, your Wildcats 38. Yeah. Gonna have a penalty flag down on the play after a nice run back. Signal is against the Wildcats for an illegal block. 10-yard penalty from the spot brings up 1st and 10, Wildcats. Number 10, Hines with the tackle. Kaufman, the ball carrier, picks up 7. 2nd and 3. Busted play there. 2-point conversion, no good. 5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Your Wildcats now lead 44-32. Take this opportunity to remind you, you have a couple of opportunities next week to watch the Wildcats compete at home. Next Friday night, the football team plays at home. We play against Pratt Skyline, who at last check was winning their ball game tonight. Volleyball is at home on Thursday. And Thursday also has home middle school sports. So we got lots of opportunities next week to watch the Wildcats compete here in the friendly confines. Aaron Green in on that tackle. It'll be 1st down and 10, Gorillas. We should also next week know our Acacia Substate classifications for the year, whether we're going to be 1A or 2A. And soon after that, we should know where we're playing volleyball for our Substate. Oh. carrier there, number 10, 5 yard, 4 yard gain, brings up second down and 6. Recovered by the Wildcats. It'll be first and 10 Wildcats on the 35-yard line. Wildcats call the timeout, second charge of the half.
Nelson with the tackle, Colin Cole the ball carrier, about a 2 yard gain. Got another final out there. Central Plains 55, Kinsley 6. Timeout charge to the Wildcats, third and final charge timeout of the half.
Fight,
by Cole. In of about three on the play. Brings up fourth down and two for the Wildcats.
Everybody open! Everybody open! Everybody open! Everybody open!
Nice putt that time. 45-yard kick down to the 15. Be first and 10 Wildcats from their own 15-yard line. Timeout called by the Gorillas on first down. It'll be short loss on the play. Brings up second down and about 10. We do believe that is the third and final timeout for the Gorillas. Brings up third down at about 11. That will be our final play of tonight's ball game. We do thank everyone for their attendance and participation in tonight's contest. Please do help the facility staff out by cleaning up your trash and